drafting alone.
I think that's fair, and they had a great draft here. We'll see what they cook up for draft number two. Here is IG. What? Ban away Varus is their first pick.
God V does play Varus.
He does.
But that is an interesting first ban. It's a particular targeted ban, right? And that says to me that their first pick is going to be something important.
I think Azir. That's the pick that most people don't like into Varus in particular. So maybe IG have got something very special cooked up right now. Ryze going to get another ban, of course. Nobody's going to get to play that. Feels like for the whole weekend here as a champion, far too strong.
Yeah, it's pretty strong at the moment. It was strong before the small buffs that he has received on the latest patch, which we are on now. So, I mean, getting rid of that Ryze, it's going to be like the new Kalista, essentially.
Yep.
Which is something we're still yet to see banned just at the moment in this draft. And speaking of not being banned, Alistar has been unattended as well.
He has. He saw a great performance from PYL in the last game. Hecarim, though, going to get taken away from Akon. Fizz actually banned away kind of from Zatai. Maybe from Rookie, he probably plays it as well, but certainly more of a top lane ban here. And IG, what do they want for their next one? The Dream is still alive. Echo might still be around.
Oh, the Dream is... Oh, it's so real.
It is real.
There's
Kalista.
One ban left.
Going to be the last ban there for IG. I wonder if Eldred think, you know what, we're on the red side. We can't give it to you. Most teams have been banning it on this side, but we'll see what happens in about 20 seconds as LGD consider their last ban.
If they don't ban away the Alistar, if they do say they opt for the Echo ban, then it leaves open the Alistar to be completely available to be picked away. There's no need to early pick a pressure jungler this game, because there has been no jungle bans. They're a lot more targeted, so you can afford to go for the support style pick first. Don't reveal anything that you're really planning on doing, as the Sivir is the last.
Yeah, an interesting last ban from LGD. Decide that Sivir is the pick they don't want to give to IG, so two very strong mid laners, two very flexible players, and Echo is available if they want to take it away, but it's a long time since we can get to there. It'd be a great way to end our evening, but we'll see what happens here for IG. There are so many strong picks on the ball for them to take away here. That's definitely not one of them on the volley there. Alistar, Rek'Sai, Gragas. I don't think IG can afford to give away Gragas in particular.
They could opt into picking the Gragas. They could opt into picking... There you go.
Wow! That's... They actually first pick Echo.
It's high enough of a priority. We've seen it banned. And if it wasn't banned generally, it was also picked earlier in the day. So getting that Echo straight away onto Rookie most likely, but it can be done in three lanes if you want to get adventurous with it.
You can. We'll see what happens here, but Rookie feels like the sort of player that has a champion like Echo. Just down pat already, gets so many reps in. Very creative, massive playmaker. Excited to see what IG can bring to the table with the champion. But LGD might be doing the VG gaming strat. Did not work for them in that game. I think we can say that much here. They just tried to take too away. And yeah, they'll calm it down a bit. I think Kakao's happy he's going to get one of the high-pressure junglers because they're both available. But Rek'Sai Alistar there for LGD.
And evidently looking towards getting the Rek'Sai over the Gragas as well. So they're saying that the aggression is going to be evident early. They're looking to put high pressure down, maybe irrespective of the rest of the draft right now, potentially looking to put in some lane swaps into effect. And I mean, the Alistar and the Rek'Sai is just so adept at diving at the moment. It's no surprise the Gragas, because that is the response to the Rek'Sai, both top level junglers, for having that early pressure availability as well as the scaling relevance with the tanky stats. And a Vayne.
Yeah, a Vayne pick there as well. But I think it's a really smart read from IG on this draft to actually do what they did and leave the junglers open, because TBQ is a much better Rek'Sai player than he is a Gragas, and Kakao's a great Gragas player. So I think IG just went, we're like 99% sure you're going to pick Rek'Sai and give us Gragas, and we're fine with that, of course, just taking in their second rotation. So I love the early stages of the draft from Invictus Gaming. I don't know how Echo fits into most team comps, of course, because he's a very new champion. But LGD, we'll see what they want to take away. PYL's Alistar in particular is a threat here. And Akon's going to get Rumble, and Imp's going to get Twitch.
Yes, he's got his own skin. Hopefully he does play it.
You have to.
You kind of have no choice now. Imp, we've got the Rumble. We didn't actually know what the Rumble was going into just yet, is the point that was about to be made. And I actually wouldn't even be surprised. I know it's just a hover and it's unlikely, but the Jarvan would actually be really good against Rumble.
It would be. I mean, we do like to see people play aggressively onto Rumble. If you get on top of him in particular, he can struggle despite all the damage he can do in close quarters. LGD, though, put together, again, a kind of a... I guess it's a somewhat brittle comp because you're relying a lot on positioning with your big high-impact ultimates from Rumble and Twitch, with Alistar again sort of as the only peel. But it worked out last time as IG complete their draft.
Wow.
And it's Aurelia coming through and Annie there as their support.
So they've got the rounded out team comp, and it's a very weird team comp to say the least. They've got the Annie now, so they were missing an initiation tool essentially. Kiddies is going to make up for that with the Annie. They've got the Echo, which provides this really unique amount of, well, ridiculous damage firstly, but has this very unique ability to actually dive as well, because you can place that area where if you actually walk in it, you're going to get stunned. So he can just zone you from this spot, and then Gragas has got an availability to throw out anything that he likes, not in that area because they're not going to be there.
Gotta be such a baller as well. Oh my god, he actually picked it. I thought he was just trolling Rookie, but we get a Yasuo.
What is happening?
I don't know, but I love it.
It's amazing.
This is amazing. This is a great way to end the night here. It feels like a lot of comfort picks for LGD, but kind of looking through the comp, I actually love how they completed this.
They've got the Wind Wall availability, which is really good against Gragas. It works against the Vayne's auto attacks, of course, and even Echo actually stops that Q that comes out very often with a low cooldown. So Yasuo is a very good pick into the Echo, but it does scream to me that there's going to be so much action.
Yeah, I'm not sure how the lane's going to go, but I think the game in general is going to be absolutely insane. So Ty on Aurelia, going to be taking on Rumble's Akon's signature Rumble, excuse me, Kakao back on Gragas, his signature jungler, versus TBQ and his signature pick there
signatures
on the rec
everywhere.
It's trademark picks across the board here, and Rookie going to break out Echo for the first time for himself, I believe, and Golfy says, you know what, I can just beat you with your own champion.
So yeah, that's going to be a very aggressive mid lane as we have a look at the ADs, and we've got Kid on Vayne up against Imp on Twitch, and it just feels like we're throwing back a couple.
Speaking of signature champions, even PYL here on the bottom with the Alistar into the Annie there of Kiddies. If you're only going to watch one game of LPL tonight, I hope it's this one.
I couldn't be more comfortable at the moment, except the Echo, I suppose. But let's just assume that he is comfortable because he's picked it in the LPL.
I mean, it's Rookie. They snapped it up as a first pick. I would certainly trust in Rookie as a player. He's been so good. He's basically been on fire recently. He's been so good when we've seen him play. This is going to be a lot of fun.
Oh, this is going to be an amazing game. Coming into this, just expect aggression everywhere.
Well, we'll see how aggressive we can get. We're about to get under the rift. Well, well, well. We're here for our last game of the evening between Invictus Gaming and LGD. And we have everything you could want and more, I think, from a game of League of Legends. What a way to end the first night of week number 4 of the LPL as Invictus Gaming look for a couple deep wards there, maybe spotting for that lane swap, or the Vayne swap, as I like to call it.
Yeah, potentially, but they've also got the Twitch coming out. Very, very early prediction of that occurring. So I guess maybe wanting the lane swap themselves, or just happy with the 2v2 even by going there so early. Not even needing the deep wards, essentially. They're just going to be quite comfortable with putting him up there, Imp. And you're right. This is going to be an amazing last game of the LPL. Everything on offer that you could possibly want. People playing their most comfortable and best champions. And then there's an Echo and a Yasuo.
Yep.
There's an Imp with an Imp skin.
I hope. I don't think I haven't seen him yet. I assume he's using it.
We may as well just watch Imp for the rest of the game and marvel.
I think if he's not using it, we should never watch him.
Yeah,
because I would feel... I think he's disgraced as Akon, PYL, and TBQ having a party. That's a weird party, by the way.
Just pressuring near the blue buff area because they've got Imp in the top lane. And they're going to be quite comfortable. They're going to take the blue away, of course.
Yep, going to get it here. Looks like Twitch is actually going to start in the top side. Imp, I believe, starting to freeze that wave in the top side of the map. Akon, though, going to follow TBQ for the early jungles. And we are going to get that lane swap.
Yeah, so they've actually put the lane swap into effect here, LGD. They're going to be quite comfortable with doing this because this is where you start to see Imp shine. They've got the Alistar who can roam as well, which is massive because Echo, a very high-pressure mid laner, wants to put down as much auto-attack damage as possible early. You can see how much it does. It rivals that of a Yasuo, and he is an AD carry.
Yeah, and you can tell why Godfrey started Doran Shield in this lane as well. I feel like this is not a counter pick strictly, but like a matchup that Godfrey is comfortable in. It's cute that it's a signature rookie champion because Godfrey does like to do this to people. But of all the lanes to look at, this is one of the newest we've seen and going to be great to watch two fantastic mid laners go at it.
And I guess everything's exciting because you don't really know what you're going to expect from it just yet. But very comfortable in the mid lane at the moment as they're trying to put a lot of poke down onto each other, but we've got one with a Flask and one with a Doran's Shield.
Yeah, I almost feel like it's just an outplay battle between the two, potentially. Yasuo is certainly known for his playmaking, and Echo, we've all seen the highlight reels as Imp. We look in the top lane for a second.
Yes. Goodbye. He actually has the skin off. Thank you for behaving.
Of course he's using the skin. Yes, well behaved there for him. I think earned it after the Tristana game here as Rookie and Godvi just going to go back in for an all-out brawl in the mid lane.
And this is where I would probably have most of the camera just sitting at endlessly, is because their aggression is going to know no bounds between these two champions. Yasuo always looking to pressure the lane so that he can maintain control. And you can see the Windmaw being able to stop the Q there from Echo, who's going to constantly be throwing that out, because if it hits once, you can utilize your passive with your dash and just do ridiculous damage.
Yeah, we saw that trade earlier on in the lane, actually, as I check summoner spells. Godvi sort of gamed Rookie here. It's Exhaust versus Cleanse. Godvi going to dive his way in, but Rookie going to try and keep it safe. Godvi going deep, but he can't quite complete the kill.
He had TBQ nearby, so very, very able to actually put down confident, aggressive pressure. But speaking of...
Yep, pressure coming in for Kakao now as TBQ, Akon, Kitties, and the Tai all join in. TBQ gets stunned. Godvi dives back in onto Rookie, but a good parallel convergence going to put him in the stun zone. Godvi will move in there. Kakao going to go back in, but Godvi pops his cleanse. Kitties dives in to try and make the difference, but it's not enough to get the kill. PYL now is going to get locked up, and Echo gets first blood.
And that's not the person that you want to have that kill going on to. After all of that, you could see the pressure from Godvi trying to force him out, even using the cleanse out of that stun that Rookie had placed down, a very well placed stun too. Finding the stun actually connecting, very difficult to do, and they end up with a kill now in favor of IG, or LGD, sorry, what?
Yeah, it
IG,
is.
IG, yeah.
It is for IG, yes. LGD, of course, up a game, which so is where the confusion
thing,
might have come from. And IG do look to equalize here. I mean, both the top laners starving a bit. Akon's going to be happy to take some of Godvi's farm away, although he quickly returned to claim it. Zatai also farming jungle for the most part now, but no smites on either top lane are going to make that a little trickier than normal. The AD carries, though, they are free farming. That's probably the happiest thing in the game for them. But there's a reason we're focused on the mid lane. We always see an isolated mid lane in a lane swap situation. Everyone else is just freezing and doing whatever. We might look for support roams, we might look for jungle ganks, but all of this centers on this mid lane matchup.
Yeah, every AD carry at the moment just looking to scale past. They both do very well scaling AD carries once they get their items, they ramp up massive. And it's going to be a big factor in the mid to later stage of this game. Early though, you're looking at the two most aggressive laners in history going at each other with the two most aggressive champions in history, just trying to find something.
Again, it feels like they just want to outplay each other as Kakao's found Akon. Kitty's there as well, but Akon's damage is dumb. Rookie, though, going to charge himself in. Dives over the top. Z-Drive Resonance pops, and Kakao going to get that kill.
Yeah, that's slow from Rookie with the third auto attack. Basically, the Vayne passive just on steroids. Ridiculous amount of work as Godvi pushes the lane in, but Rookie again having a big impact and actually getting the kill onto Gragas.
Oh, Rookie has to be careful. PYL's coming in. He finds it, but the Yasuo knockup's not there. And I somehow completely missed that synergy. Is Godvi going to dive back in? He's level 6. He wants it. Rookie will dodge the next Q, though Godvi doesn't quite find it. That fickle narrow hitbox getting in the way, but PYL might look for a dive.
Yeah, the thing is, Rookie now level 6, able to go back 4 seconds to wherever he was beforehand. And shouldn't really be possible to dive an Echo in a situation like this now.
No, and he's just fine now with Chrono Break available. But Dragon did go to Invictus Gaming in and amongst all of that. Zatai and Kakao actually have been buddying together for the whole game, it feels like. Managed to get that objective together. In fact, they'll go do the Grump now together as well as Akon. He has so many wards in his lane, he knows he can't walk down.
It's a very, very bad prospect of trying to get some last hits even under your own turret. The four pressure, it's almost like at 7 minutes they've finally made the decision to have that four-man pressure in a side lane, and they don't really get a whole lot from it. They're working towards that turret, but they haven't overcommitted to it just yet.
No, we've actually got no turrets down just now. The 80 carries maybe preferring to secure that early farm, as Imp, you can see, now getting a bit of damage down. PYL returns to the lane to soak some experience, and the mid lane battle continues. We're actually checking on the CS. Avarice played nice here for Godvi early on, but he's actually up about 20, so doing nicely in the matchup that he picked for himself.
Very well by being up 20 CS, and you can see the lane control has been in favor of Godvi. Able to control the minions really well, push it in, and pressure Echo under his own turret. It's an awkward situation to be in the last hit, especially with Yasuo continuing to add the pressure there, knowing that he is in the 1v1. And you can see Godby really starting to put the hurt on the Rookie, but speaking of...
Might go back in, time window hits him though. Rookie wants to go back through, but he is a little low on mana. Hasn't been able to go back just yet to refill that flask, I don't think. There's a Fiendish Codex, but he's going to be forced back. And we saw it earlier as well. Eldritch stole that blue buff. Rookie's going to be forced back one more time. And Godby starting to get the lane a little out of control.
He's starting to ramp up in strength by a fair bit, especially because he has that Avarice Blade first. But blue buff...
Gonna go to Kakao. It's not a bad person to have it, but Akon's coming through with the damage. Good stun from Kitties. As Kakao's trying to get out of the way. He's running away with the double buffs. He's very valuable as TBQ coming back in. Godby dives through there, but the Windwall's not quite there. Rookie's gonna get the kill onto Yasuo one more time. Parallel Convergence gonna stun up Akon. Aurelia gets Rek'Sai, and IG wipe out LGD 3-0.
The rotations from the IG lineup there work out perfectly. You've got a level 3 Rumble, basically, who cannot provide you anything for your side right now. He's basically just soaking up damage to die as slowly as possible. So, I mean, it worked out exceptionally well for IG, of course. They capitalized on it. Echo hitting the stun. You've got Gragas, who came back in after escaping with a little bit of a cute play over the wall there. And even Kitties managing to hit the stun. Kid has been left completely unattended, hasn't even recalled until right now, but still doing an abundance of damage in that fight. And the IG side are really starting to ramp up, 5-0.
They are, and again, that aggression we talked about finally there with Kakao's Gragas being the pick that he gets to play. I mean, there's lots of scaling here for both sides. The top lane is still sort of fighting over scraps, but Akon, he is horrifically far behind at this stage. As Imp, he could be in trouble here. Kakao going to look for a gank. Imp boards him up, though, but Kakao's going to come back through. The ulti does find him. Kitty's going to dive in as well, but PYL's managed to find him. Imp popped his ulti. Kakao looking to go down, but it might not just be enough. No, it is.
Really lucky, actually. The Ignite not picking up a kill, but Imp's toxic ways. The poison is actually going to pick up a kill. That's really good, because now Imp has the money. He's going to start ramping up. LGD's only kill is on the back of Imp, and that last game that they won was on the back of Imp.
It was indeed, and I mean, IG, it's funny to see the mid lane go well for Godby, but all of the kills, in fact, 5 for 5 kill participations there for Rookie, and 2 of them are kills as well. So Morell and Omicron now completed. Rookie getting things rolling here on this Echo. We've actually come down to a 2v2 lane as Rookie. Just going to clear out some waves.
Yeah, we're looking back to standard lanes now, and it's going to be a very difficult situation for a Rumble to be in particular, but Twitch,
yeah,
just as rough.
Oh, great move there from PYL. Knocks Kid out of it. Gets the double pulverize as well. That might actually be enough for Imp to turn the fight around. Contaminate goes down. That's the first kill, and now Kitties going to get chased down. Imp going to look for it one more time. He's got double buffs. Kitties, you're in so much trouble. The last headbutt's there, forcing the flash, and now Godby and Rookie. This will be a duel in the mid lane. Parallel Convergence goes down. Timewinder hits in there as well. Godby needs to wait, but the Chrono Break dodges the tornado. Rookie now going to dive back in, but Rookie's chasing with the
pain.
Godby coming through. Five time winning. It's canceled. Glenn's flashed there. Godby still out, still alive. Ulti there from TBQ. And he does it somehow as Akon's dead as well.
What
that
was that?
So sick.
So intense. Godby hitting the wind wall.
Stone face.
Hitting the wind wall. Hitting the flash. Or the cleanse, sorry. Perfectly timed. You could see even Rookie using that chrono shift. Going back to his ultimate. Unfortunately, not getting damage from that. Was a big factor in that 1v1, and TBQ coming in just in the end there. LGD find themselves picking up kills in the most intense 1v1 to ever exist.
I mean, Echo vs. Yasuo, we talked about it. This is the sort of shenanigans that we can get. TBQ kind of being a bit of a scumbag there.
Yeah, kind of.
Swooping in to ruin the sick 1v1. But Godby, he did everything he could to make sure he came out ahead, but that was so intense.
Both players doing everything possible in their kit. Every summoner being used, the exhausts and the cleanses. Both ultimates by the end there, but ridiculous. How do we even comment on this 1v1? Because it lasts so long. You can see 2 stacks on the tornado knocked up now by Yasuo. Actually dodges it with the ultimate. Turns back around, uses the dash to get in. The passive just ran out there from Echo though. Big factor in this 1v1. The wind wall. Stopping the second half of that Q, a massive save.
Oh my god.
But at the same time, the Rek'Sai knockup giving Yasuo the ultimate because his tornado missed.
Oh! I also noticed that right at the end there, Godby's flow just refilled to full so he didn't die.
Yeah.
That was so close. I'm glad they replayed that.
So am I.
That was very interesting. That's a duel you can watch back time and time again and probably learn more things. But we expected big things from the mid lane matchup 1v1. It is finally delivered. But PYL trying to keep Rookie down here. Godby at this point. Those knockups come into his lane. He's got the static shiv. Good to go. TBQ actually going to get chased out of the jungle as Kakao might have found Akon here. But level 7 finally for the Rumble, though he is forced to flash out.
Yeah, forcing the flash away from the Rumble. Finally getting those items and starting to ramp up. But it's not really amounting to anything just yet. They're waiting for Rumble to start getting some kind of items. He's only just got that Haunting Guys finished now. He wants some Stork Shoes if he wants to have relevance in a big team fight around an objective. Until he actually has that available, it's very, very rough for this Rumble to be in a position like this. The Aurelia is always going to start getting stronger and stronger. Hits that Trinity Force and the spike is massive. And even Imp at the moment, though, is 2-0. Very big, and against the Vayne, it's going to be big for team fights.
I mean, it's funny to see LG sort of scaling up here, but the gold is so even because of all the kills that IG have gotten. Although Imp is getting a little bit stronger,
trying nice to condemn.
Assert dominance, but yes, excellent condemn to keep Imp away.
Saving his life of his teammate, to be perfectly honest. I think that would have actually got him one more auto attack, and that was all it had. That no flash available from Imp, but they can go straight from what is almost the kill on Kitties to the Dragon.
And that's 1-1 now, actually, for the Dragons. LGD going to pick up their first here. And if the game wasn't close enough already after that Echo Yasuo duel, it's about 700 gold ahead for IG, even on Dragon, slightly ahead in turrets there for LGD. We're almost 15 minutes in, the game is delivered and it's very, very close.
When I saw that the score was 5-0 and we had a massive echo, I was starting to question how it was going to go, but turned around almost immediately as I ever questioned that LGD on the back of Imp and even that God V getting the kill there in the 1v1, massive for them. They've started to push themselves through at 15 minutes into this game towards the mid-game strength. Again, the big issue that was just mentioned is Akon, and he's in a bad position too.
Kakao's found a slow Kitties, gets the stun after the knockback from Kakao's ulti. Kid's riding in as well, and Akon pops down an equalizer, but Kid scoops up the kill.
Essentially a non-factor right now is Akon, not really able to do anything. 0-4, and Invictus Gaming can just continue to be a pest and harass him and deny any chance of actually getting items and maybe look for a win off the back of that. At the moment though, they do have a big Twitch and they do have a big Yasuo, so they need to work around having these two maybe leave Rumble in a 1v1 where Zitai has to stay up there and just keep him busy so that they can try and win a 4v4.
I think keeping Zitai busy might be important because honestly, until just now, Zitai was kind of useless as well, but he'd been getting more gold. That's the big problem here. Akon, 0-4-0, 37 CS versus 2-0-3, 75 CS. Zitai, he's got his Trinity Force parts. He's finally going to be a bit more relevant. Even some bonus gold coming through there as Kid takes out the top turret to even up the turret score. It's a very close game. IG find themselves net ahead, but it is Imp and Godby that can make it count.
Yeah, it's going to be on the back of those two to see if they can make a count. We're looking at a turret being taken right now. The response to Kid actually getting that turret just beforehand. And it's going to come down to the next big fight, I feel like, who's actually going to have a lead. Irrespective of the gold difference right now, the gold is on different players and different champions. So you've got Imp, who's massive for team fights, always going to be able to put down the relevant damage just because of the range of that ultimate. The spray and pray, or the rat-a-tat-tat, whatever you would like to call it, is really just both.
Imp here looks to get a tower now as well. Denies as many CS as he can. He's going to try and make sure this cannon will go down. It should be, nope, not
oh,
quite,
the
unfortunately.
Real battle.
Yep. Oh, it's close. Cannon does die. Imp doesn't get credit for the tower kill, but he'll get a bit of extra gold in the area as TBQ and PYL lining this one up.
Not just lining it up, they were walking in but did not find it.
Yeah, Kakao coming in as well. Rookie phase dives back. Doesn't have his ultimate actually, must have used it in an earlier off-screen duel. So didn't have it there if he got all in. Kakao in the right place to detect the roam coming through. And PYL's been missing for a lot of this map as Kid continuing to get himself free farm. Actually was going to pop back into the mid lane for a second to look at items. Not too sure what Echo's going to do. He's got a need to see large rod right now. Yeah, Luden seems sweet, but Godby is a phage already.
He has a phage.
Yeah.
Working towards a Black Cleaver or a Trinity Force.
Yep.
What?
I mean, they seem fine.
They're both good. Don't get me wrong. It's just that he's opting towards a phage when he could be opting towards either a Bloodthirster or an Infinity Edge Power, even the Blade of the Ruined King. Instead, he's going towards a phage, which says to me that he's looking to be tanker. He's looking to absorb more damage, especially in a 1v1. But speaking of 1v1s...
Oh, Imp going to make Rookie's life very miserable there as he does come through. Parallel convergence to cut off the retreat, though. Rookie doesn't burn his ultimate. He's safe for now, but he can't stop the pressure on this turret.
Not having to blow the ultimate is a big deal. It's going to help him a lot. And the pressure from LGD going to be enough to take the turret, though. And that's going to be the third turret in favor of LGD.
Yep, they do get a third turret. All the outer turrets now failed. IG do have one. Zatai is working very intently on the other, another one in the bottom side, but can't quite finish it off by the looks of things. We do have a divergence in the builds, though, for AD carries, as we see a Zeal and a Dagger there for Kid. Probably a Static Shiv or a Phantom Dancer, but Imp, he's going to go Purple Boot. He's got the Brutalizer lined up for a Ghostblade.
Typical Ghostblade bye-bye Imp. He loves getting that, and that's when he really starts to assassinate people. You can see he already made an attempt in the mid lane. It translated to a turret, and you cannot let Imp play his own game right now. If he's left alone, if he can actually come into a lane invisible and actually make an impact, every time that he does it, they get something from it. The side of Invictus Gaming needs to recognize this fact, not necessarily wake up to it, but find a way to work around it so that they can either deny it, kill him when he tries to do it just by predicting where he's going to go next, or just stop him entirely.
See Rookie though, doing a bit of jungling, cleans out the blue buff. Gonna get the wolves here as well as Kakao sails by saying, hey, those are mine. But Rookie, again, maybe needs a bit more CS. Godfrey's still about 20 ahead in this matchup, despite the fact that the gold lead's gonna be very close, if not ahead for Rookie, just due to the kill participation. And it's been a bit of a slower game after that gank from Imp, as we've slowed things down after the crazy duel in the mid lane. But Baron's up in 20 seconds for the first time, and Dragon's back in 40.
Yeah, Dragon available, not likely an avenue of attack for either team at the moment. Again, the top laners, I feel like LGD are slowing this game with good reason, because the rest of their team does scale and they need Rumble to start having something. As we can see, the big item from Aurelia now finished as well.
Trinity Force done there for Zatai's got the Ninja Tuba in as well. If IG wanted to get aggressive around the Dragon, they've got a great timing window to do so.
They do have a good opportunity to do this. The IG side have got all of the big items they would like. Maybe the Needlessly Large Rod being upgraded would be a big factor in the next fight for the side of Invictus here. Rookie might be looking for that Ludens. Could be a Zonya's or a Deathcap. We don't really know just yet. But either way, they're probably in a stronger position than LGD are to actually take this in a 5v5.
LGD have actually started the Dragon, so trying to beat IG to the punch, but Rookie positioning over the backside as Imp tries to the lane, but just clears out the creeps there instead. And it is going to be Trinity Force there for Godfrey. He's got his Merc Treads, but the Zeal's already done.
Yeah, the Trinity Force is going to be the plan here, and that is very interesting to see a Trinity Force coming out onto a Yasuo opposed to any other item build. It does provide a lot of effective stats for Yasuo, who now has the Merc Treads as well, but we'll see how it actually pans out when it comes to team fighting, because that is still a very interesting decision.
I mean, the Sheen proc obviously works with Steel Tempest, his Q, so you get value there. I mean, the mana is probably the only thing you don't get out of the item, so it's interesting. It's very mid-game focused, but I guess the nice little thing is it does give you the extra crit you need since the IE change to make sure once you get IE that you actually get back to 100%.
I guess it's the fact that he's gone for the Static Shift followed by the Trinity Force that is a very interesting thing to note, is that because you always need that Static Shift because it's such a strong laning item, it gives you the wave control and the attack speed as well to help you out. It's just very interesting that he's decided to go in that particular build order when he could be rushing some kind of damage.
I mean, it's also expensive. That's the other problem maybe for Godfrey, but he's on a nice clip right now to get that Trinity Force Rookie though. Looking for that Ludens like you mentioned, that's my guess as well. It's tends to be what we've seen from the few Echo games we've managed to glimpse, but the Dragon did go to IG as a result. Kakao actually chasing TBQ, but that ulti did not hit as TBQ tunnels to safety.
No, that was a little bit late there from Kakao, unfortunately.
Ambitious.
Not able to hit that explosive. Yes, ambitious is a very nice way to put what that was. He didn't actually hit the explosive cask. Rek'Sai getting away TBQ is quite comfortable with that. And nothing really going to come from it. It's time to reset.
It is a little bit, as Akon's actually managed to pick up a bit more farm. Need to see Large Rod has been completed, but IG have dodged all of the Rumble equalizer potential around those Dragons. So LGD, you can tell they're putting these waves in, just trying to get the farm. It's scale time.
Rumble has completely foregone the Sork shoes at the moment to get that Needlessly Large Rod and rush into his Zonyas. He is looking to teamfight now, at least have a relevance in a teamfight, to be alive for a little bit longer than he otherwise would have been. If he went for Sork Shoes, they're sacrificing another 3 to 5 minutes worth of farming, and it looks to me like that's not what they want to do. but they want to fight as well.
Tim is coming down. Imp going to get condemned into the wall. PYL, they're going to try and save him as the teleports come through. Zatai's already down here, though, and Kid and Kitties are both low. The equalizer down. Akon's actually, Imp's going to get the kill dead with the passive, and Rookie and Godvi are at it
again.
Parallel convergence down. Cleanses off the exhaust. He's standing a little too far close. Chrono break there for Rookie. Ulti out to reset flow there onto Zatai, but it's too much damage as Kakao takes him out.
That's just so intense every time they fight. They're trying to find something here, but it's very unlikely.
Kakao comes in. Kitties, that was a mistake. Goes in too far and gets picked off by TBQ. And Invictus Gaming trade kills there, and a pretty even actually as a tie might go down and give LGD the win, and Akon picks up much needed kills here, although the tie looks to be getting away.
What is happening?
Awesome stuff. That's what's happening.
So much awesome stuff. Watching it echo at a Yasuo 1v1 is the most satisfying thing in the world. They just so many mechanics in such a small amount of time, as we can see the Trinity Force for the Yasuo now completed as well. That'll help a lot with his trading capabilities, especially against the Echo, just because he's got the Sheen proc on top of it. He's not able to be super sticky to an Echo, so the fact that he has the Sheen, he's got the Phage for a bit of mobility boost as well with the auto attacks that proc it. It's going to be good for keeping on top of Rookie, and it's going to be a bit weird to keep on top of anyone else, though.
I mean, I guess we'll find out just how good the item is, because the time to use it is right now. 24 minutes in, two item power spikes right here for this Yasuo, but Rookie actually went for a Zhonya's Hourglass, as you can see there as well. So if there wasn't enough outplay potential before, we're going to add a little bit more.
There is so much more now.
There is indeed. So if we didn't have enough mechanics, Rusty.
Oh, we need more mechanics. You can always have more mechanics. There's never a limit to how many mechanics that you can put down in a small amount of time. But in saying that, we're looking to see more of a team-based decision here, not just raw mechanics. And LGD looking to accelerate their own builds. Once the Zhonya's is finished from Rumble, I would suggest that would be the time where they really want to start fighting. Even though the Trinity Force is done now, they just need the Rumble to have that relevance, you know? So having a Zhonya's to keep you alive for an extra 2 seconds is a big factor in doing that. But you have a look at the side of Invictus Gaming. They've got their big items now. They're only looking to add on top of that. You've got the Aurelia with the Trinity Force. Her dueling, ridiculous. You can keep Rumble wherever you like at the moment. There's nothing that he can do. They've got a lot of outplay potential. They've got the Zhonya's finished. Two items onto Kid. They're massive. So now they're looking to just complement their item build, continue their lead, and try and just push out and control the rest of this game and finish it methodically.
I mean, you say lead, there's actually less than 1,000 gold between these two teams at this point, so
that's
balance
true.
Very tenuously. I think both teams are looking for two item power spikes. They're about to hit them all at the same time, it feels like, as Akon hits his Zhonya's. Now Frozen Hearts, though, done for Zatai as well. Dragon's up in a minute 35. Things could get very intense.
Yeah, things may get a bit heated around that dragon. I mean, you said it. They all started to hit their two-item spikes, and the gold lead isn't actually that big, so I take that part back. In saying that, the two-item spikes, you've now got the Zhonya's for the Rumble. If ever there was a time for you to look to fight on the side of LGD, knowing that he's always going to stay behind but has accelerated his build to complement the rest of the side. The Trinity Force has finished. Two items here for Imp as well. He's going to probably try to assassinate someone. They'll most likely turn that into an objective or a dragon. On the other hand, if they catch him trying to do that, well, then it's not going to go well for LGD.
No, a lot of this is about setup here, but I do agree with you earlier. I think IG did have an aggression advantage in the last few minutes of the game, but sort of been neutralized now, so we're going to reset what's been such a close first 27 minutes of the game here. Again, the outplays have been insane. Rookie's actually going to get himself down to the bottom side of the map and do a little bit of split pushing for himself. Both teams trying to create some space because they know Dragon's coming up, but that Baron's also a possibility as well.
Baron is a very real possibility. Both teams having a hyper carry AD that can take down that Baron extremely quickly. Both, in fact, even having the Echo and the Yasuo are exceptionally adept at taking that down. And I mean, it's going to be very hotly contested as to what they actually go for with this next objective-based rotation.
I'm just going to see what happens in about 10 seconds because that's when the dragon's coming back up. Imp's quite strong. I mean, in this case, we've kind of gone through it all. Everyone's strong. Even PYL has got his talisman back in, but Kitties has his as well. Lots of engage options here. Lots of outplay potential on both sides. Even Rookie going to come back into this fight. He's got a Sheen now finished as well, maybe looking for a Lich Bane. There are about to be some fireworks here, and IG, crucially, are actually looking for their third dragon.
Yeah, the question comes down now to how they are going to actually engage this fight. If they look to give up the dragon, which is very unlikely because we've just said for the past 2 minutes how they should all be fighting, that they need to set up for the dragon perfectly. It first stems from the vision control. Now, Invictus Gaming don't have a ridiculous amount of vision control. The response from LGD is quite sparing also. TBQ, having started this dragon from the looks of it, might have just been procced by someone else. You might be looking to see the Alistar engage against what is most likely going to be a Gragas engage. It's going to be very difficult for Invictus to actually force it onto them.
Yeah, teamfights are complex in this game, to say the least, as TBQ entertains the idea of a steal, but there's too many members of IG already in the area. Throws out a Prayseeker just on a win, but IG going to claim their third dragon. Imp, he had to go back. He wanted to finish his last Whisper, but Zatai being a pest in the top side means that LGD are forced to concede that dragon.
And that's three dragons now to Invictus Gaming, so evidently not something that they're looking to fight for just yet, which means they're biding their time while they just lost control of the area completely. Echo rampaging through the bottom side of the map, jungling when he's not in lane. So always, always out of vision is a big factor here for the side of LGD. Can they go somewhere where they don't know when the Echo is actually a visible area on the map?
I mean, I think the biggest problem with Echo is we've seen what that W can do. Although Imp, invisible, truly invisible, forces Kiddies to pop the Talisman. I mean, Imp, he's kind of wanted to do it all game long, but if he ever really wanted to kill somebody on Twitch, I think now might be the time.
Now is definitely the time, but you can't really do it against Kiddies in particular, especially when they're not alone.
Well, TBQ's trying to find Kakao, but he's got caught out instead. Mini-stuns into the walls of Tai, straight on top of him, and PYL says, what do I do? Actually, he's going to go down as he forced to pop the ulti. Godby pops his way in, gets the double last breath. Rookie gets knocked up there as well, but Chrono breaks his way to safety. Now going to try and go for the redive, but Godby is cleaning house on Rookie. He is very dead, it feels like. He's forced to flash into the pit, but PYL's going to find him to clean up for him. And that's three clean kills to LGD.
They get the fight that they want. It's engaged onto them, but the Gragas wasting that ultimate early, the biggest engage tool from Invictus Gaming. Instead, LGD turn that around. They go onto PYL. He just presses the ultimate, knocks them up, and then Yasuo hits the two-man tornado straight after and ults them himself. So they're suspended in an area where Imp is hitting them for about a five-second period of time. And if you manage to live through that when Imp has a last whisper, I would be impressed. As we're about to see how the Gragas does kind of waste that ultimate there, puts TBQ away through the tunnel system. Thankfully, that was a pre-placed tunnel. PYL knocks them up. Twitch popping them with that spray and play. Prey. Yasuo actually uses the ultimate at the same time as TBQ returning in from a second tunnel. And really, there's just nothing that they can do at the moment. The side of LGD just rampaging over them. Imp completely left to his own devices. And Godby having much more of an impact than Echo ever could have dreamed of.
I mean, that damage was just silly. And I think you're right. You mentioned the Alistar ultimate. The other person they tried to initiate on was TBQ. Yeah. The other massive tank on the team.
Yeah. The two people that you should not be going on were essentially the two people that went on one after the other. So too much actually used, too many resources put into getting the tanks, even though I guess they were out of position, but you can see how quickly that turned around onto its head, and IG forced to run away. They give up the Baron and a lot of kills.
Yep, they do, and LGD find themselves with a Baron, a gold lead now finally coming through for them as well. 3,000 gold and counting. Godby is monstrous here in this game. He had the crit cloak for the last little engage. He might just have enough for IE, or at least a good Jesus.
That's
he just
it.
Finished it.
That's the whole Infinity Edge.
That's a lot of Infinity Edge. Less than 32 minutes in, and Godby is ready to go. 100% crit, massive damage. Welcome to bad times for Invictus Gaming.
Yeah, good luck, Invictus. I know that you've got all of the scaling and items in the world, but that's a whole lot of Yasuo coming at you.
I actually like what Zatai's done here. He's just all armor. He's like, I don't care. I need to live through all this AD damage. I don't care about you, Akon. As these Baroned up minions, they're doing work as PYL is posturing for a dive.
I probably wouldn't care about Akon either, to be honest, if I was anyone on the side of Invictus Gaming. 0-4 and Akon. 4. Starting to have an impact, but it's not really enough to be worthwhile. You can actually afford to stack that armor on the side of Invictus Gaming, and funnily enough, that starts to give them a window where they might be stronger.
Oh, they might go in. They actually just layer all the ulties in there, kid. Forced to pop is to try and get out. Rookie pops his Zhonya, so Godfrey got out of position. Might be going down. Chrono Break takes out Godfrey. Rookie's going to charge it. Gets a kill onto Twitch. That's the double. And IG just wipe out LGD.
That was quite literally almost 100% Rookie on that Echo. The way that he just played that fight destroyed and decimated the side of LGD. They tried to dive. The engage was right. The Alistar on top of an equalizer. Imp freely hitting at the back, but instead it gets turned around massively. Just watch the way that Echo plays this fight. You can see the engage comes through. The headbutt pulverize on top of an equalizer. Imp freely hitting, but Rookie gets that stun in place, uses his Zhonyas, so that the second that he comes out of it, they're in a horrible position, right? He still has his ultimate available after all of this. Picks up the kill, uses the dash, and saves it for Imp.
Yeah.
From here on out, that fight, Kid basically didn't get touched as well, which is definitely something worth noting. But the way that he played that in the middle of the fight is ridiculously good.
That was insane. I mean, again, what we expected from this game was some pretty brilliant League of Legends, and that's what we've got here. 2,000 gold now up for IG. Fourth dragon, coming back up for them in 45 seconds there as well. And IG, I think, finally being filled with the confidence. The game was even before, we've got a slight lead, but I think they finally feel that they can teamfight LGD, which we honestly couldn't even say about this whole series, let alone this game.
Now, I agree that they can fight them, but the question is, how are they going to be able to enact that actual fight? And we've seen when Invictus Gaming actually do the engaging, they get killed. But if LGD do the engaging and it's not onto Kid or Rookie, then LGD lose. So at the moment, what we're seeing is a lot of engagements, but not a lot of priority targets actually going down.
It's just too many outplay ultimates.
There's a lot of outplay ultimates. There's a lot of mechanically intensive champions right now. They've got a Vayne and an Echo up against a Yasuo Twitch. So, I mean, it's very difficult for both teams to get onto the carries of their other respective team. But in saying that, if they don't, they usually lose the fight.
They're going in. TBQ's getting a little too low. Godfrey, though, blocking it up with a Windwall. Brilliant equalizer there from Rumble. But Kid's trying to cut around. Akon gets into the front lines, and Rookie takes a massive front load of damage. Imp as well will zone them away, and nobody's dead. But LGD, make sure they get the dragon. I say that tentatively.
Oh, he's got it.
Kakao stole it. Fourth dragon now for IG. And LGD like, well, we have nothing else to do. A Kakao, though, might get caught out of position. Rookie gonna dive back in. Pops his on his parallel convergence in the middle there as well. Goes back to his ulti there. Now dives back in. Gets the kill onto him. Rookie's gonna die. But Zatai's now gonna get caught up as well. Kid still cutting around the fight. Godfrey's still fighting there as well. He's actually got himself a double. PYL is dead. And Kid, he needs to be careful. There's no ulti here for Yasuo. Gets the knock on the wing walls down. Gets the kill. Jukes out Zatai. Gets his flow back in.
Oh my god!
Somehow gets the double!
That was ridiculous. I could not explain to you in one small sentence how he just outplayed that Aurelia. The Windwall usage, the fact that he dashed through the Windwall multiple times with Aurelia's ultimate ticking, everything. Getting the double shield, so much work there from Godfrey. And the end of that, it was essentially a 4-for-5 trade.
Let's see another team fight, Rusty.
I can't even continue. It starts off, Kakao's caught in the dragon pit. Rookie finds himself super low, but has to use that ultimate immediately to make sure that he stays alive. Meanwhile, Imp is doing his best job at living. Rookie goes in to secure Imp, but finds himself a Godfrey, who now has Kid to deal with. You've also got Aurelia to deal with, but in saying that, the way that he kites this is unbelievable. He gets that second ultimate, uses the sleeper, denies vision, knocks him up, gets the auto attack into crit, dashes through the Windwall as he places it down a second time. And he has the shield, gets the knock up again. Unbelievable.
He dashed just enough to get some flow there.
Yeah.
And yeah, unbelievable is the word for this whole game, Rusty. It's been absolutely bonkers.
My mind is just...
And look at that gold. 300 gold between these two teams. 37 minutes in. Godfrey has a GA. Rookie has a death cap. And this is just absurd. Baron is back up in 3 seconds. And IG are in the area.
It's ridiculous. What do you even say about this game before it actually ends besides what the hell is happening? It is dead even, basically, with the only big win condition that you can point out right now is the four dragons. Invictus Gaming, they managed to steal away the fourth dragon before that fight even began. Massive from Kakao right there. The next dragon is not up for a little while, so it's not too bad for them at the moment on the side of LGD. They've still got the opportunity to catch someone out of position or just secure the dragon area. But speaking of...
him going into Tai could be in trouble. TBQ going to dive through, but that Echo W going to shut out all attempts of a chase. So Imp, again, he can get a pick. That's a way that LGD can get themselves ahead, but denied nicely there by Invictus Gaming. All reset once again.
They actually can't see that until the baseball hits it. So that was invisible. It was just there as a precursor to if they over-engaged, Rookie was going to go in to capitalize on that.
Yeah. You definitely don't want to walk into that one, by the way. It's nasty.
No, you don't.
And we see Rookie. His Sonya's parallel convergence usage has just been awesome so far. We talk about Rookie, a player that does have a deep champion pool, that likes to make sure he's on top of the meta and he's ahead of the curve. This man already looks like he's close to mastering Echo, and it's been great so far. Even Godby's counterpick of the Yasuo, which, as I said at the start of the game, is extra sweet against a player like Rookie. This is, I think, the game that encapsulates what we hoped the whole series would be like. And last game was fine. A good win there from LGD and maybe a bit of a misstep there from IG. But game number two has been everything we could have wanted and more. And we're still not done. We're not even close.
We don't even know what's going to happen next right now. 38 minutes into this game and anything could happen from here on out. And that is ridiculous to think about in and of itself.
Yeah. I mean, two teams, two very strong teams that are close together. Baron is back up, but both teams are deathly afraid of going towards the pit. We saw what happened to IG last time. I don't think they want to repeat that from game number one. And in a game this close, you cannot afford to make a single mistake. This is such a huge test, not just of these players and their mechanical ability with their very fancy champions, but this is a test of teams here. How well can you make this work? If PYL, you are the general and shot caller you're talked up to be, this is the moment where you need to pull it out big for your team.
And not just that, everyone needs to step up hard. The decision making does need to be on point, but even with just such high mechanically intensive champions, they need to all perform to their maximum capabilities in every fight. With the gold lead this marginal, and the fact that they've started Baron.
This is a really smart Baron from LGD. They've got good damage, but IG realizing kind of get them off the Baron here. Kakao gonna pop in. The rest of IG are here to fight now as well. They're trying to go in. Imp's actually popped his ulti and his ghost blade. Oh. They wanna pick on the kiddies. They're gonna get it. That's important here now. Akon gonna pop down the equalizer. Rookie's forced to get off the area. It's only one kill, but that's all they need.
Imp doing so much damage right there. Getting two crits in a row with the expunge. Takes down kiddies from basically full health. And I mean, they started up the Baron before. They now found a pick from it, and they're going to start it up again.
This is a 5v5, remember, because Baron is doing damage to LGD, but Kiddies is dead. IG have to make something happen. PYL's trying to find a pick. Ulti there onto Kid, though. It might be able to start things off. Kid's not going to die. Kid Debs, yes, into the wall, but Godby takes him out. Rookie pops his own. His parallel convergence is there. Chrono breaks his way back in. Dives onto Imp. Rookie, he's trying to do so much work. He's got the double. He puts the W down again. Dives back in. There's the triple. Not going to get the pincer. Godby already died, but it'll take the triple and the ace for Invictus Gaming.
ZTai and Kakao just sitting in the middle of the fight that entire time. Kid would just not die. He would not go down. Actually managing to basically take out the GA of Godby, which was just finished before this fight. And now that's their turn to go into the Baron. Rookie again, look at that shield amount that he gets from that. Unbelievable. They pick up a Baron. They win a teamfight with an ace, and Invictus Gaming just turned it on without kiddies.
And again, it's all about execution in this game. The gold was dead even before we started that. Now 4K up ahead for IG. Let's see another insane teamfight, Rusty.
So my eyes always gravitated to the fact that Kid was then caught out of position. He popped the Flash, the Mercurial Scepter, and is just trying to kite Godby, who manages to get him by the very end there. At the same time, Rookie uses that parallel convergence. He comes back into the fight, bides his time until he could flash onto Imp and manages to live for long enough to throw out his Q. Puts down the W at the same time, by the way, so he's getting a lot of shield and just overconfidence. The fact that Kakao and Zetai can sit in the middle of that fight and just do so much absurd amounts of damage between them allows Rookie and allows Kid to work around that, and they come out ahead.
And the double Baron Cannon's gonna make easy work of that turret. IG got the fifth dragon in that exchange there as
they
well.
Did.
So they are so strong as they move towards the bottom side. LGD somehow have to find a way to hold on.
Life is not too good for them at the moment. They are definitely struggling, but they've always got the capabilities of an insane team fight between Imp, between God V, between even Acorn now, starting to have this massive amount of relevance. They need to turn on the fight, but it's so hard against the Dragon 5 and Baron team to find an eye in or find a way into actually getting a fight.
Windwall's trying to get some work done here, but they can't quite get in. Kakao's actually just almost face tanking here. TBQ Imp's will actually looking. Go in. Imp is looking. It's important that he gets someone here. They actually get a kill onto Rek'Sai. That's Echo getting a pick off there. PYL not going to dive his way in, but it's a tie straight onto Imp. Imp cannot live through all of that, and the damage is too much here. Akon's going to pop his Zhonya's, but the tie's going to clean house for the last fight. And in one of the most insane games I have ever seen, Invictus Gaming come out ahead.
Dragon 5 and Baron is so overwhelming and so difficult for them to actually get through. On the back of Kid, Rookie, and even Kakao played a phenomenal game. This IG side turn it on. They managed to pick up the second game against LGD.
And GodV had an insanely good Yasuo game as Rookie collapses into his chair. That was a tough game to win. And the craziest thing is, that was just the equalizer.
I would collapse into my chair after a game like that as well. So many mechanics, makes a man tired.
Yep.
Unbelievable. The 1v1s, the duels that came out of a Yasuo and an Echo. The team fights, there is just so much going on that it's almost impossible to even keep up with. The closeness of that game up until like the 35 minute mark plus, where it just exploded with one team fight for Invictus Gaming. That was a game.
That was 40 minutes of awesome execution-heavy League of Legends with some of the flashiest champions in the game and some of the best players in the world. That was awesome stuff to watch. And IG, congratulations, you get a tie. take your point, you deserve it.
After all of that, you end up 1-1. You feel like you deserve the 2-0, but LGD managing to pick up that first game for them, and they only do equal that out. But how good is Echo?
I mean, awesome to watch. I think time will tell about just how good he is on a competitive stage, but as far as a breakout goes for Rookie, that was a pretty nice breakout.
Definitely a nice breakout. The fact that they managed to do so well with the new champion as well, he's managed to master that so expertly in such a short time.
He has, and that's the thing I love about Rookie. He's just a player that, again, wants to always be one step ahead. To be fair, so does Godvia. If he'd had the option, trust me, he was playing it there as well. And that was an admirable counter pick of the Yasuo as well. Looked great in the matchup. Again, basically lost the game. They lost that game with GodV being very far ahead, very strong in that game.
Yeah, they did lose the game. But of course, GodV, you have to give him all the commendation in the world. He just did so much work and it was so close, so intense, but unable to pick them at the line. The IG side as a 5 coming through too strong.
They would, and that will be one to watch again here, as those team fights and those duels were just phenomenal. But for that, we are going to unfortunately have to end our LPL broadcast. I don't know what else we can do, but we will be back tomorrow to catch us for more day 2 of week number 4. For myself, Rusty, Froskura, and Seda, and all the League of Legends fans that got to appreciate that, go back and watch again. I know I will, but for now, we'll just say goodnight.